Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. This is IPM, Intelligent Power Module, or SPM, Smart Power Module. Its part number is SCM1246MKF. When we search its datasheet, most of the time SCM1200M series or SCM1200MF. M that is molded and MF that is with heat sink. But this number is MKF. I don't know what is K. There must be some definition for K, but there is no data available for the word K. This internal block diagram is for this module. This module is used in LG 4-ton inverter AC board. It is 30 ampere power module. It have two portions. The one that is logical drive unit. The second is power drive unit. This deals with high voltage. 300 to 400 volts are applied here and it drives AC loads, inductive loads. This side, it communicates with microcontroller, with computer. When we test with multimeter, most of the time we test this high power section. We can say 99% faults are there because it is dealing with high current. Most of the time any IGBT or any body diode that is damaged. In this session we will verify its this stage using multimeter. And in upcoming session, we will make its complete tester. We will apply signals here and we will check it with the truth table provided in the datasheet. In this IPM, there are three sections. We can see section 1, section 2 and section 3. All three sections are independent from each other. Just only one thing is common, that is high side battery voltage, positive voltage. That 25 number pin is common for all collectors of IGBTs. Emitters of all sections are separate. Why? Because this module can be connected with three-shunt resistors to monitor individual section current. Or it can be connected to single point with one shunt resistance. So that is current monitoring technique. Let's check it. Initially, we verify the short circuit here in the power stage. That is here. If we place in this direction, this is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 pins are in separate block, then 2 pins that are bootstrap capacitor connection. Then again 6 pins, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is last pin, pin number 14. Then 15 and 16 bootstrap capacitor for second stage for high side IGBT. And then the next 6 pins. And last pin 23, 24. 25, 26, 27, 28 is missing, 29, 30, 31 is missing, 32, 33. These two pins which are not connected, these are internally connected with pin number 25, that is positive DC rail. Set multimeter to diode. We can check continuity with 25 and this cut pin that are disconnected. So these are collectors for each section and it is connected internally to these three pins. Now we have three emitters. The first emitter, this emitter and this emitter. The last pin 33, if you place it here, 33 that is emitter for this section, this emitter for this section, this emitter for this section, and this is output pin. We can say each section has three pins. In the first step, we will check 26, 25 and 27 number pins. 25 is coming to collector of this IGBT. Here is a diode. So if we place red lead at 25, red lead positive will reach at cathode, and 26 negative will reach at anode. This diode must be reverse biased. 25 red lead, this 25, 25 red lead, 26. So it is open. That is good condition. That means diode is reverse biased and IGBT is open circuit. We reverse the lead and it is giving indication. That means this diode is good. If it gives open circuit in both directions, that means this diode is open circuit. If it is giving continuity here and here, might be the diode is damaged or IGBT is short circuited. Then pin number 26 and 27, we will check lower side IGBT. If you place red lead at 26, black lead at 27, it is open. Now reverse the leads. One diode. It is good indication. One side open, second side, one diode forward biased. Normally, one set, second set. Open, open. Same way, we can check now these three. Here, here. We can also check with 25 because these three pins are internally connected to positive rail, that is pin number 25. Same way, we can check here. Open, open. Just only what we will do, we will check in this condition one diode forward voltage like this. Then we will move the both leads across this diode. Here, 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 here. Swap the leads. Open, 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 open. So this is good indication of the power stage. Then this IPM have internal bootstrap connection. So we can also verify that connection, bootstrap diode, resistor, and this connection is here. 32 will reach at pin number 8. This is 32 and this is 8. It is given continuity. Then this output pin, pin V, that is 29, 29 will give with this bootstrap capacitor. That's good. And W will give with this pin, the last pin. These internal connections are good. In upcoming session, we will make its test circuit and we will apply signals in each section and we will check physically the response of the IGBTs and we will verify it's this logical circuit, because there are many safeties which are being handled, being monitored all the time during its operation. So we will do a practical test in upcoming video. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.